Good evening, everyone. So it's the day of the big storm, or actually the night of the big storm, and just out cruising around here, doing a little local action, show everyone what kind of snow we're getting. So at my last check, I stuck a ruler outside, and it looks like we had about 7.5 inches of snow so far, and it's about 9:30, and I guess this is supposed to go on all night long, baby. You can just see it's just impossible to keep up with these roads. I know they tried to plow these a couple hours ago and they're just already covered again. You can see this genius right here just walking right out in front of the road. I mean, just, oh, that's it, guy, run. Yeah, because that's good. That's good, guy. Hit me with a snowball.
Uh-huh. I'm not aiming for you. If I wanted to hit you, I'd hit you.
Look at this. Jeremy sees the camera, and so for the first time, he's going to actually do some labor.
I did 90% of this. This is bullshit.
He didn't do 90% of it.
You can't say bullshit on the video blog.
This is all volunteering too, Paul.
Well, Bill, how you doing?
Doing great.
Yeah, a little snow deck, or a little emergency declaration tonight.
We have one?
Yeah, guy, didn't you get the text?
No.
Yeah.
Wait, Pennsylvania's declared disaster?
No, Mark declared one in the borough. So Jack brought pizza, but Pauline brought, what did you bring?
I brought the after effects, the date.
The bag of restraints.
Yes.
What are these for?
This is for dinner and a date. Or if you were bored afterwards, I suppose.
Oh,
you have to ask Jeremy and Bill. They seem to know more about it.
Oh, come on.
What is this?
It's video blog, guy. It's video blog on the night of the snowstorm. You didn't think I'd let this escape us. I mean, look at this.
I tried.
We haven't had this snow in like...
Anyone knows those aren't my restraints. My restraints are monogrammed with my initials on them. And also, who was shoveling snow?
Is that the three of us? I didn't see any old brittle ladies out there.
Oh, it's getting deep.
Yes, it is. Almost 7.5 inches of snow.
That's what you... And the other thing I've realized tonight is that Beef is losing his touch. The snack locker is empty, Beef. And even on snow night, the practical jokes continue. Remember those paper shreddings from a few video blogs back? I go to my locker. Hey, there they are. And they even say Chieftain 645. Good one, Nicole. Good one. All right, so you guys can see how bad this has obviously gotten in the last like 4 or 5 hours. Just got word the Red Cross is opening up a shelter in White Oak. There's some people stranded in cars. I probably passed no less than probably a dozen or so cars on the side of the road with people with their engines running. They just absolutely can't go anywhere. I'm gonna guess we probably have at least 10 to 11 inches of snow right now. I mean, these streets are just not even touched. I mean, no one can keep up with it. So, headed back down to the base, and I guess we're gonna try to hopefully go out and see if we can rescue some of these folks and get them to the shelter, or at least get them out of their cars for their night.
There's
nuts, huh?
There's not, well, I tried to shovel a thing out, maybe to go. There's nowhere to put it.
I mean, this is easily a foot. What?
Jason.
Yeah.
I talked to Jason and he said that he can't get out, but he's somebody, if they can get him at the end of the driveway. My hair's frozen.
I mean, this is insane. I've never seen snow this bad.
Have Frank how bad it is.
I know. Here comes Jack. It's nuts. So here's Fox ready for action tonight, dude. You look like the Red Baron. And this is a weird sight. We have no power in White Oak.
and stop by 4 p.m. tomorrow.
All right, that's copied, Jack. There's some people in the room. Go ahead.
We're right on 30, right outside the mattress, Matt's furniture, if that's what you're talking about. There's a whole bunch of cars. Do you just want us to look for just his friends, or do you want us to see how many people we can actually get to a shelter?
Yeah, let's concentrate on getting those initial people, and then if you want, you can talk to those people and ask them, you know, what their plans are. They may have someone else coming in a four-wheel drive to get them, or if they want transportation down to the shelter, you know, let them know that we can, you know, make a couple trips or send another vehicle, you know, whatever we need to do. So, hey, it's like, I don't know, like 3-something in the morning. We did I think we got 6 people that were stranded off the road and down to the shelter. We did oxygen service for another person. And so just gonna see what's gonna happen the rest of the night here. But for right now, we'll be clear.